The first step in installing Joomla on a remote host is to create a database for Joomla to use. To do this, I'll need to go to the cPanel for my web host account. I'll go to the homepage of Bluehost and log into my cPanel by entering in my login info here and clicking on Control Panel Login. This is the homepage of the cPanel. It might look a little bit overwhelming, but don't worry. You'll become familiar and comfortable with the parts that you need to use. To create a database for Joomla to use, I'll scroll down to the database section and click on MySQL databases right here. I'll type in a name for my database and then click on Create Database. On this confirmation page, I'll just click on Go Back. I can see here that my database has been created. I'll copy the database name and put it into my login info document because I'll need this information for the Joomla installation process. I'll just highlight the name of the database here and copy it. And then I'll go ahead and put it into my login info document. Now I need to add a new user for this database. I'll type in a username here. And then I'll click on Generate Password to create a strong password. Once this password is created, I'll come up here and copy this and put it into my login info document, as I'll need this as well during the Joomla installation process. Then I'll click on Use Password, and then Close. Now I'll click on Create User, and then on this page I'll just click on Go Back. If I scroll down a little bit, I can see that the user that I just created is listed right here. I'll go ahead and highlight this username and copy it, put it next to the other database information in my login info document. The last step in creating the database is to add that new user to the database and give it full privileges. To do that, I'll make sure that the user I want to add to the database is selected in this menu here, which it is, and then make sure the database that I want to add this user to is selected in this drop-down menu here. Then I'll click on Add. On this page, I'll select All Privileges and then click on Make Changes. And then on this page, I'll click on Go Back. I can now see that I've created a database and I've added a user with full privileges to that database. Now I can move on to the next step of installing Joomla. I'll need to get a copy of the latest version of Joomla, which I can get by going to joomla.org. I'll click on this button here to get the latest version of Joomla. The package I want is the full package right here, which is a zip file. I'll click on the download link right here and download a copy of Joomla to my desktop. Then I'll go back to the cPanel and go back to the homepage of the cPanel by clicking on this link here. Now that I'm back on the homepage of the cPanel, I'll scroll down a little bit, and in the file section, I'll click on File Manager. This pop-up window is asking me what directory I'd like to go to. The default is the web root or public HTML, which is where I want to put the Joomla zip file I just downloaded. It's already selected for me here, so I'll just click on Go. Once I'm in the File Manager, I'll click on Upload right here, and then browse to where I've got the Joomla file. When I find it, I'll double click on it, and the Joomla zip file will start uploading. After it's done uploading, I'll click on this backlink to get back to the file manager. The zip file of Joomla is now in the root directory of the server. I'll need to unzip it or extract it before I can start the Joomla installation wizard, though. To do that, I'll select the file here, and then click on Extract, and then I'll click on Extract Files. This window is showing me the files that were extracted during the extraction process, and I'll just click on Close. All the files of the Joomla zip file are now extracted and on the root of my server. I'll scroll down and delete the zip file since I won't need that anymore. Here it is right here. I'll just select it and then click on Delete, and then Delete Files. For the next step, I'll need to go to the root URL for my site. Since I haven't yet pointed the domain name I purchased to this server yet, which means that I haven't changed the DNS or name server records for the domain yet, I'll need to use the temporary URL. There are a couple options around what URL to use to build your site on. If you're building a new site with a new domain name, you can go ahead and change the DNS records for your real domain name and point it to the server right away. I'll show you how to do this in another movie. The second option is to build your site with a temporary URL. You might choose to use the temporary URL during the whole period you'll be building the site if, for example, you have an old website already up on the web, hosted on a different server, and it's using the domain name you want to use for your new site. Let's say you want to build a new version of this site on Joomla, and you want to have it hosted on a new server with a new web host, but you don't want your old site to go offline until the new one is ready. In this case, you would build your new Joomla site with a temporary URL. That might have been a bit hard to follow, but just keep in mind that you can either build your website with a temporary URL or the live URL that you have pointed to your site. For the purpose of creating the site in this course, I'll use the temporary domain name to start off with, and I'll soon point the real domain name to the site. The temporary URL will differ from host to host. With a Bluehost account, your temporary URL can be found in the information that was sent to you in the welcome email. I'll open up my login info document for the project and get the temporary URL from the information Bluehost sent me. Here it is right here. I'll just click on this link here in the document to go to the front end of the site, which is where I need to go to access the Joomla installation wizard. If the temporary URL isn't a link for you, you can always just copy and paste it and put it into the address bar for your browser. Once I click on this link and go to this temporary URL for my site, I'll be brought to the first page of the Joomla installation wizard. On this page, I'll need to select my language. English is already selected, I'll just click on Next. Here, I can see the results of the pre-installation check. I want all these to be green yeses, and they are, so we're good to go. Under the recommended settings, I've got one red on, which is different than the off that's recommended here. It's about displaying error messages, so this isn't a big deal. I'll just leave it and click on Next. This page is the license agreement for Joomla. You can have a read of it and then click on Next. On this page, I'll need to enter my database information for the database I set up earlier in the cPanel. The host name right here will almost always be localhost for most web hosts, and that's what it is for a Bluehost account. So I'll enter in localhost for the host name. I'll enter the username, password, and database name by copying and pasting this info in from my login information document so that I make sure that I don't make any mistakes by trying to type them in. Once all that information is entered, I'll click on Next. This page is about enabling and configuring an FTP layer of Joomla. I don't need this right now, so I'll leave it set to no and just click on Next. On this page, I'll enter the name of my site right here. Then I'll enter an email address and a password for the super administrator, which is the highest level of access. The default username for the super administrator is admin, which is what I'll use with this password to log into the backend or Joomla administration side of the site. Below here, I could click on this button right here to install some sample data that would populate my site with a number of pages, some sample text, and some modules. It's a good idea to do this if you're trying to teach yourself Joomla, as it can help you see how Joomla creates content. However, since I'm taking you on a guided process, and because installing the sample data would mean that I'd have to go through the process of deleting it all, I'm not going to install it. Instead, I'll start with a blank site and build it from the ground up, so I'm not going to click on Install Sample Data. We'll just leave that alone, and I'll click on Next. This message is telling me that I haven't installed the sample data and is making sure I want to really proceed without doing that. I'll click on OK. On the last screen of the installation process, I see this message right here that Joomla has been successfully installed. And over here, there's an important message telling me that I have to remove the installation directory before proceeding. To do this, I'll go back to my file manager in the cPanel. And then I'll select the installation directory, which is right here, by checking this box, and then I'll click on Delete, and then Delete File. Now I can go back to the last page of the installation process and click on the admin button right here. If I were to click on the site button, I'll see a very empty looking site with a default Joomla template because nothing has been built yet and I haven't installed my template either. So I'll click on the admin button here and we'll be taken to the control panel of the Joomla admin side of the site where I'll need to log in. With the username admin and the password I created during the installation process of Joomla entered here, I can now click on log in. And here's the main control panel for Joomla. At this point, Joomla is installed on a remote web server and is ready to use.